What's going on, y'all? Chuck Nun Face. Got an interesting one today. Got one from Custom Knife Factory. This is the new CKF, Custom Knife Factory. Anton Malyshev at Tohus on Instagram, T-O-H-U-S on Instagram. BLAVA. So it's an interesting knife. Very distinctive looking, as you can tell right there. Big old sweeping belly. So this isn't a review. This is just kind of checking out this knife. I've had it for about a day now, and I've just been kind of finger banging it a little bit, and I've been forming an opinion. I'm not sure where I'm at with it right now, but we'll take a quick looking at it. Quick look at it. Just get some impressions. We'll do some quick size comparisons. There it is against the Spyderco Para 3. And here's another Spyderco in Endura. This is the Endura Warncliffe, so it's about the same size as the Endura Warncliffe. Let's see, Endura XM18. It's gonna be a little bit bigger than the Endura. And let's see, we got a Grimsmo Rask, quite a bit bigger than the Rask, but the Rask isn't small. It's just it's efficient in its design. It's not a small knife, as you can see. It's basically the same size as an XM18, the Rask. But, you know, it's just very efficient in design. What else can we look at? What else can we look at? What do I have handy that's somewhat familiar? There is a Microtech, one of my favorite knives of 2024. Released in 2023, so it didn't really count, but I got one in 2024, and it is an absolute favorite of mine. Let's see, another Hinderer right there. Here's that Hinderer Project X. Basically the same size as the Project X as well. But one thing that you will notice is that big, tall, tall blade, which I really like. I really like that about it. Titanium scales, titanium frame lock, mill titanium clip. Clip is nice. It's got that nice milling right in there, and it's got that blue, subtle blue, like a denim color. And then also on the back spacers right there, blue anodized. I'm not normally a big blue guy, as you see, as I just had my Hinderer, which is in battle blue right there, full TI. But the blue is nice on this. The blue is nice. The titanium is finished really nicely. Really nicely. It just feels great. It's like almost like a vapor blast or something like that. So it's a very fine media tumble, I would say. And it's really nice. Fully milled. My first impressions when I picked it, when I took it out of the pouch, was how light it was. It is not heavy. I don't know how, what the specs are on it as far as weight goes, but it is light. Also, as you can see, it's got those Damascus collars on both sides. I'm not one for Damascus, Makutai, all that stuff. However, it's subtle on this. Basically, I don't mind it, but you're never going to sell me a knife based on the fact that it's got Damascus or Makutai. It's just, I'm not into it enough. But those collars do look nice. And as you can see, it is M398 steel, which on paper is a higher performing version of M390. More carbon, more vanadium, things of that nature. Going back to the pivot collars, I looked, because CKF kind of sends you everything. Now, these knives are made in China, shipped from Russia, finished in Russia, completed in Russia and all that, but they're made by the old, I think it's Kevin John Factory, who did, I can't remember the line of knives that he had, and they kind of gave you everything because it just makes servicing easier. Now, you used to only be able to get these directly from Custom Knife Factory, but now NC Blade is the US-based retailer. So they, I think, have pretty much exclusive rights to new drops. So in here you've got your bearings, an extra set of bearings, an extra set of washers, thumb stud, backspacer, pivot, but no different collars. So that kind of screws all that. So it kind of makes me think that maybe the collars are, maybe the collars are kind of fastened to the knife itself. And then of course you get your card right there. This one was completed on April 20 of 2024. It's number 86, CKF BLAVA, BLAVA knife. DI Zerk, Zerkutai. Where's the Zerk? Is it the pivot? I I don't know. Might be the Pivot. Not sure. In any case, that's what that is right there. So, comes a little, you know, little microfiber cloth, but no chocolate anymore. I guess they're not putting in the chocolate. So, you used to send them with a special little Russian chocolate, but that isn't there anymore. So, yeah, looking at the knife. I mean, it's nice. I mean, I dig it. Let's see the blade size right there. It's 1, 1, 2, 3 and a half, probably like 3.6, 3.75 almost on the blade. And yeah, I mean, that's the most distinctive feature of it right here is that big sweeping belly. So, you know, just kind of get my mind around it right now. One thing I did notice right away is it did kind of feel Chinesey. It had that feel to it. I haven't had a CKF. I used to have a bunch of custom knife factory knives, but I haven't had one in a while. And this one, I was tempted to get it because I do like Anton Malyshev's designs. The Makosha, he designed the Veshka and the Makosha for CKF. And then the Sukosha was somehow redesigned by Anthony Marfione in some sort of collaboration, but it's originally a Tohus design or Anton Malyshev. And so he designed this one as well, and I'm a big fan of his design, so they kind of got me back into the CKF game with this one. And I am enjoying it. I like the blade shape. Kind of reminds me of the Bastinelli / Microtech Brachial. Jeez, I can't remember anything right now. Kind of reminds me of that Persian style blade. One thing that should be noted, and oftentimes this will be a non-starter for me, is that tip of that blade can be touched very easily by the finger. Now, like I say, that could be a non-starter for me. Like if it was something that was back here, like with a typical drop point knife and you could feel it back here, you run a big risk of cutting yourself as you're putting it in your pocket. But you have to know this, is that tip is right there. And when you're putting your hand, if it's sitting in your pocket like this, and you're running your hand down here, your hand is not really going to be coming anywhere near that tip because that tip is way up there. But it is something to kind of make note of. So more on that as I get some more time with it and some pocket with it and I do an update down the road here. So yeah, that's going to be it for me. Give me a follow on Instagram if you haven't done so already, @Chuck_Nunface. Go ahead and subscribe to the channel. I certainly would appreciate that. Thank you to those who have already subscribed. Drop a comment, share this video out there, hit the like button, send the alerts, do all that sort of stuff. And stay tuned for the next one. CKF Anton Malyshev to us. Peace.